Hi everyone, I am Shahan Laik. Welcome back to my channel. So what is McCune-Albright syndrome? Basically, you can see this image, which is very, very common, and it is asked in various examinations like PLAB examinations, like USMLE, NEET, PG and DNB examination, that they show you this spot. This is cafe owlate spot. This can be found unilaterally, so one-sided this spot, and they will ask you about which syndrome. So this is McCune-Albright syndrome. Let us discuss in details about this McCune-Albright syndrome. So what is this McCune-Albright syndrome? This can be generally found in the girls, and it can be found with increase of adrenal hormones and also thyroid hormones. So these two hormones will be increased in the body of this girl. So hyperthyroidism and hyperadrenalism is found. Another thing which you will notice is gigantism. What is the meaning of this? Gigantism means this person will be very much tall and stout. Along with it, you can also found acromegaly. Certain part, maybe particular portion, maybe the jaw of this girl is increased in size. So that is particular portion of the body when it increased. So that is gigantism and acromegaly. So gigantism and acromegaly. So these are the two features also you will find in this girl. Another thing you have to find is this one, that is that is known as rickets. So you can see this femur has been crooked. And this deformity in radiology, it is known as Sheppard-Crook deformity, which is very, very important. Sheppard-Crook deformity. Another thing you will notice, this is known as the well circumscribed lesion with ground glass matrix. So you can see this radiology is showing ground glass matrix. So all these are actually referring to a kind of dysplasia that is found in this child. So I will tell you about this, but before that, let me tell you about another important thing, that is the hypophosphatemic rickets. So these childs also suffered from bending of the knees, which bending of the femur bones. These are rickets, and this is hypophosphatemic. That means phosphate level has been decreased in the blood, so it is known as hypophosphatemic rickets. So I have discussed about three important things. One is the hyperthyroidism, and also hyperadrenalism, gigantism, and another is hypophosphatemic rickets. So all these are present in the girl. Now let us talk about the classic triad. So there are three important things that can be found in this McCune-Albright syndrome. The first is the precocious puberty. So what is the meaning of the precocious puberty? Basically, when you observe this girl, you can find out that her breast has been developing and her pubic hairs is found and menarche has been started. So bleeding has been started. So all these things has been started before a particular age, before the puberty age of the girl. So this is known as the precocious puberty, which is one of the classic triad of McCune-Albright syndrome. Another thing which you will find is the cafe owlate spot, and this is also unilateral. Particular side of the body will be having cafe owlate spot. So what is the meaning of this? Cafe owlate spot means cafe or coffee like spot. So this can be found. Also, it is known as coast of mane appearance. The same thing, okay. Cafe owlate spot is also known as coast of mane appearance. So this is the second triad, and number three triad is the polyostotic fibrous dysplasia. So fibrous dysplasia. So what is the meaning of this term, fibrous dysplasia? Basically, if you look at, if you observe the bones of this child, you will find that certain portion of the bones has been become fibrous. So the bony material is replaced by fibrous material. So this is known as fibrous dysplasia. Fibrous dysplasia. So can you remember the three important classical triad? The classical triad is, number one is the precocious puberty. Number one is precocious puberty. Number two is cafe au lait spot. Number two is cafe au lait spot, which is unilateral. Cafe au lait spot, which is unilateral, also known as coast of Maine. Coast of Maine. And number three is the fibrous dysplasia. Different skeletal fibrous dysplasia. Different portion has been become fibrous. The bony material has been replaced with fibrous tissue. So this is fibrous dysplasia. So three important things, and that is precocious puberty, cafe au lait spot, and fibrous dysplasia. So these are the three important classical triad, along with the normal features like hyperthyroidism, increase in thyroid hormone, increase in adrenal hormone, gigantism feature, acromegaly features, and rickets features are found in this patient. And basically, what is the management? So we manage this patient with the help of this aromatase inhibitor. Now, aromatase inhibitor like testolactone. So testolactone is the drug that is used, that is aromatase inhibitor. Another is ACRM like tamoxifen. Tamoxifen is used. Another is estrogen receptor antagonist. Estrogen receptor antagonist like fulvestrant. Fulvestrant. So three important management. One is aromatase inhibitor. Aromatase inhibitor like testolactone. Testolactone. Number two is ACRM like tamoxifen. And number three is estrogen receptor antagonist. Estrogen receptor antagonist like fulvestrant. Fulvestrant. So these are the three aromatase inhibitor, ACRM, and estrogen receptor antagonist. These are the three management of choice. Now let us go to the next slide, and you can see the cafe au lait spot in details. So you can see this unilateral cafe au lait spot, and sometimes this can this is found in the chest and the thorax region, and you can see in the back also you can find this cafe au lait spot, and you can see it has not crossed the midline, so unilateral. Here also you can see it is a little portion is visible, so cafe au lait spot. And when a baby is born, you can see a particular line of demarcation. Can you see this? This portion is cafe au lait spot, and this portion is also having cafe au lait spot, but they are completely different and they do not cross. So you can see they do not cross the midline. So unilateral cafe au lait spot in the trunk, in the thorax, in the abdomen, in the back. So all these are cafe au lait spot. But sometimes this can be also found bilaterally. Here it has crossed the midline, but anyway we can understand the this is also the same thing, McCune-Albright syndrome. Now let us go to this slide where you can see here the spectrum of cafe au lait macules. Basically these are known as macules. So cafe au lait macules, you can see in different portion of the body, anatomical location different. You can also find this on the face, though this is uncommon. You can also find on the neck portion, you can see, and you can generally this trunk portion is very much common, and sometimes also on the flank region, and this is the back region, and also on the neck region. And this girl is very much common in question. Always this girl is asked in the question. Now this one you can see it can also be found on the neck region. So all these are irregular, and they have a jagged irregular border, which is very very important. Let me tell you about this one, which is very very important, and several times this is asked, that is known as jagged irregular border. So if you look at the border, you can see it is irregular. Can you notice this border is very irregular? So irregular and jagged border, irregular, jagged border. Can you see irregular, jagged border? So jagged border. Another is its ends, starts or ends in the midline. So it will start with the midline and ends in the midline. So start or end, if you find out that this is the starting point, then it ends in the midline, or if you find out that it starts in the midline. So either it will start in the midline, or it will either it will start in the midline, or it will stop in the midline. So this is also very, very important feature. Another variable, anatomical location, it can be found, like face, neck, also be found along with the normal location, like the trunk and the flank. Now let us go to the next slide, where I will discuss about the fibrous dysplasia. I told you, you can see this scan, and you can see the bone scan, where you can see the particular arrows. Can you see this particular arrows? What are these small arrows representing? They are actually showing that the fibrous deposition. So can you see the small black dot like depositions in the skeleton bones? So these are fibrous deposition on the bones, and this is known as the fibrous dysplasia. Fibrous dysplasia. So the bones has become dysplastic, which is also very famous feature of this kind of syndrome. And you can see another thing is the rickets. When you look at the femur bone, basically you can see it has become bended. So basically due to the decreased level of phosphate has been decreased, so hypophosphatemic rickets are also found, you can see in the image of radiology. And this is also showing the same cafe au lait spot on the face. So all these are very, very important feature, and sometimes the girl is very tall, gigantism feature, acromegaly, certain parts has become very long, maybe hand or maybe jaw, or all this are also found along with increased in the adrenal hormones and also the thyroid hormones in the body. So why I am ending with this slide, because this is the particular slide which is asked in various examination, and you can now easily understand this is unilateral and it is present in particular side of the body. This is McCune-Albright syndrome, and they are pointing out the cafe au lait spot, and this girl is having McCune-Albright syndrome. So this is the end of this video. If you like this video, make a thumbs up and subscribe our channel for getting many more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you like this video, please write down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.